For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My brothers and sisters, we give thanks to God for the guidance, the strength, that and faithfulness that he has given to his daughter, Reverend Stacy Lea Rhodes, under these difficult circumstances. She will share with us what the Lord has laid on our heart for us at this difficult time. But before she comes, I invite us at all, sing this little song with me as she further prepares herself. Bless thou thy word unto our hearts and glorify your name. We sing about two times, then she will come. Bless thy word unto our hearts and glorify thy name. Bless thy word unto our hearts and glorify thy name.
We praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, family, immediate family, biological family, adopted family, church family, of our dear departed sister LaJoy Evangeline, I greet you well this afternoon. I stand here not just as pastor of our sister LaJoy, but also as someone who considered LaJoy not just a member of my congregation, but also a friend. LaJoy was also a neighbor, as we lived in the same, within the same vicinity, on the same street to be exact, in Faith Street.
Hallelujah.
We will see her again. There is no more pain.
when we will lose, when we will laugh, when we will talk, when we will share again. I invite you now to turn with me in your Bibles to 2 Timothy 4 and verses 6 through 8. And I read for us from the King James Version. For I am already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but also to all who have loved his appearing. The word of the Lord. Words of comfort and challenge to Timothy. And I believe which was to come. So what can we say today? What can we learn today? What can we take today from this awesome statement that embodies not just Paul's life, but embodies LaJoy's life? There are three thoughts I want to share with us today. One is that this statement, I have fought the fight. You would have heard persons sharing the tribute today speak of LaJoy's conviction about one thing or another. And here is Paul in this little statement to Timothy, and by extension to you and I today, Paul is saying what kind of life he lived. Paul is saying who Paul is and who Paul has been. Paul is talking about what and who Paul has believed. And so when he says, I have fought a good fight, it was to give his protege Timothy a glimpse into the kind of life he had, both before and upon meeting and making Christ his Savior. It is a statement of conviction. It reminds us that there is a life that is meant to be lived, a life of purpose that cannot be truly found until we find ourselves embodied, embraced, involved in a relationship with Christ. This was the kind of life that our dear sister lived. She fought a good fight on many levels at various stages of her life. I was privy to be let into some scenes and snippets of LaJoy's life, even before she joined us here at the Loveland Park Baptist Church. And I have heard even others mention that hers was not an easy life in the beginning, that there were points of struggle, there were points of challenge, there were points when perhaps a lesser person would have given up. But she, from very early, found the strength of a woman to persevere, to push on. And no doubt, it is that life which she herself lived, that fight she herself fought, that put her in the kind of position to love and to empathize with others, to be able to touch the countless lives she touched, and to reach out to others, and to help them in turn to fulfill their purpose as well. I have fought a good fight. It suggests that life wasn't always easy, yes, but somehow there was something she found deep down inside that she always kept on fighting.
Yes.
And I want to say a word here, that even when we come into the relationship with Christ, even when we come as members accepting Christ as Savior, becoming part of the body of Christ, the fight alone yet, we still have to fight. We have to fight to keep doing the good and the right. The same Apostle Paul reminds us in the book of Romans that the good really matter much. Eh? It don't really account for anything. I want us to understand that as Paul makes this statement, I have fought a good fight. I have run the race. I have kept the course. I have finished the course. And I have kept the faith. Paul was also saying, he was drawing attention to the fact that it's not even me doing it. Amen? It was a confession to suggest that he was able to live his best life. He was able to finish his course only by the grace and the mercies of Almighty God. No wonder he was able to say, I have finished the course and I have kept the faith. Any one of us who knows LaJoy knows that even before her personal commitment, she was living or striving to live a godly life. And even after she made her commitment to the Lord, we know that she was in the process of becoming a woman of profound faith. My God, when you would talk to her after she got sick, when you looked at her countenance, I heard one sister share the other evening that sometimes when you go to visit her, you wonder if she's sick. She had this faith. She had something deep down inside of her that kept her, that motivated her. Something, someone on whom she was relying was strength that could not fall from just physical strength. To finish one's course, to live a life of purpose, to live a life that matters, it means that we do so by keeping the faith, by having a personal growing relationship with God, by trusting God, relying on God, communicating with God, depending on God. Because when all else, including sometimes our very own families, fail, God will never fail. No wonder the psalmist said, when mother and father forsake me, my Lord will lift me up. Such was the faith of our daughter. I recall the many nights when our Bible studies were held right here on those first couple benches. And if there were 4 or 5 or 20 people here, rest assured, LaJoy Wright was one of them. She had this thirst, this wanting to know more about God. And I can recall one instance when she said, even in her illness, that joy was the epitome of learning and serving. She has been such a wonderful example to all of us, reminding us that even and especially at our lowest moments, we are who we are by the grace of Almighty God. And so we don't let go of God's hand. We don't turn away from God, but we seek to always walk with him, to always stay close to him, so that he can guide us and lead us in a right path. LaJoy's purpose came from God. This is why the statement, I have finished the course, I have kept the faith, is not about LaJoy, but it is about the God who kept her, the God who is still keeping her, the God also keep you and me. So he kept her. She knew him and she trusted him. So that as we hear the words reverberate again, I have kept the course. I have finished my race. I have kept the faith. It is as much a statement of conviction, that which I know and believe, as it is a statement of confession. I only did so by the mercies and the grace of God. Finally, thirdly, this statement of Paul, this statement of the joy to us this morning, is not just one of conviction and confession, but I believe there is all to remind us that as we live our best lives, rooted and grounded in a personal, growing faith relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, that we are doing so not for the rewards of men, but for the heavenly reward of God, our righteous judge. I believe no amount of certificate, trophy, plaque, award that a joy would have accumulated over her time as an excellent teacher and educator, or even within her church family, within her community, as she often serves as a justice of the peace. Nothing she could have got compared with the wonderful glory of that which has awaited and is even now being granted unto her as she ushered into the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
There is a in Paul's words. Listen to it again. He says, finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me.
Yes.
And not for me alone, but for all who will believe. Friends, I want to close this mini sermon by encouraging us. We don't work for the praise of man.
Yes.
after all, even when this life is over, even when flesh falls away, nothing can compare to the glory God has in store. So my brothers and sisters, we mourn. We are sorrowful. She's gone, but she's gone to a better place, and a place where you and I can see her again. My hope and prayer is that today, all of us, family, church family, whoever we are, whoever her life has touched, will get to the place where like a joy we can say, with conviction and confession, in consolation, I fought a good fight. I have run my race. I have finished my course. And I have kept the faith. May God help us that this too become our prayer in Jesus' name.
Normal around them, that you, O God, will not forsake them.
remember, Lord, not only the family, but also her church family, many who mourn and grieve deeply. Remember, O God, in a special way, those members of our church family who are overseas at this time, who have been themselves, Lord, torn by the fact that they cannot even be here. But Lord, we thank you that even prayer knows no geographical boundaries.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, that even as you comfort our hearts here in Jamaica, you are able, O God, through your omniscience and your omnipresence, to comfort the hearts of our loved ones abroad.
Yes.
So Lord, we look to you. We call on you. We depend on you, Almighty God, for truly there is no other hope that we have but you. So Lord, our prayer today, as we place ourselves and especially family members once more in the palm of your hand, is that you help us to live. To live for you, Lord. To live the way our sister lived. So that, Almighty God, we will live lives of purpose, lives of meaning, lives that are so wrapped up and tied up and tangled up in you, O God, that when others see us, they see only you. Bless in a special way this morning those members of her family who have not yet made a personal decision to accept you as Lord and Savior. Lord, we pray that even this service, this time of fellowship and thanksgiving, O God, would be a time of challenge for them. That, Lord, they will draw closer to you. As the joy was drawn close to you, may